Hello again, welcome back to another video. I'm sorry nothing got uploaded last week because I was taking a bit of a break. It's not to say I haven't been out shooting film. I have. I've been out shooting with the Rolly 35 and the Voigtlander. I have developed the negatives, but I haven't done any printing so far. But later on this week we will look at some test results, sample images, and see if we can discern any difference between the two. In operation they've been identical, to be honest, but this arrived today. I managed to pick this up last week. It's been a long weekend here in the UK. We had the Friday and the Monday off from work, and the weather's been quite glorious, so it's been very nice. Winters are long and dark and cold here, so it's quite nice to get out in the sun for a change. Okay, this needs a little bit of a bit of spit and polish, doesn't it, just to clean it up a little bit. A bit of metal polish maybe. Yeah, it does look. There's no key with it. So it's another folder with a case, which is rather nice. It's a Zeiss iKON. So German. Not sure of the dates or anything. I haven't really done any revision on this one. It's not really an in-depth review, it's just an unboxing and quick overview. Red window, so this is a 6x9, tell that by the placement. Watch me as I fumble my way around this one. Oh, that's clever. So there's your viewfinder. Highly complicated, you look through there and compose your image. Okay, that is a folder. It comes out and should lock, which it does. So on the front of this is a Zeiss iKON Telmar. It's a Netar Anastigmat, 4.5, 111 centimetres, so that's 110 millimetres. So that would tie in with it being a 6x9. Up here we've got the shutter speed, so we've got T for time, bulb, rather limited choice of speeds, 125th being the top, so this is a pretty old camera, 125, 100, 50, 25, and this presumably top dials around, which it does. There's a little dot there that you can see, line that up with the shutter speed that we desire. It's a leaf shutter. Lens doesn't look too bad, although it looks as it has been cleaned, but okay. And we've got a little viewing window up here, which you can twist. It's got the horizontal and the vertical compositions in one. So you can look down from the top, or you can look down with it that way. It's more like a landscape mode. That would be in the portrait mode. And then we have aperture selector, so 4.5, that goes right the way down to 32. That's a really small aperture. Interesting. Shutter cocking, I would think, would be this lever here. So let's see if we can put it on T. To fire the shutter, give us a clue. It's going to be that one, and then we can see the state of the iris blade. Oh, I'll turn the speed, idiot. So the aperture ring is at the back here. So close that right down, we can see the state of the aperture blades. Looking fine. It's not click stopped or anything. It's yeah, it looks pretty good. Yeah, that's working. Try slow speeds, they're normally the ones that give the most trouble. looking okay. There's a self timer. Again, needs exercising, sounds a bit croaky. Does work, but needs exercising. Condition is lovely. This bloody thing will focus. There we go. Chrome works nice. That's in very nice condition. Lovely condition, really. That bit can get folded away. To open the back, slide in the direction of the arrow. And it's a lot better condition than that Jubilar that I had. What is it saying here? Zeiss iKON film, B11S, 2.25 by 3.25, so yeah, that's what we call 6x9 nowadays. I'm guessing it's 120, but we could be wrong. I would say that is 120. The film gets advanced from this side over to that side. So, oh, it's just on a pop-out system, that's cool. Spring to keep the pressure on. Well, it's not 620 because the 620 has a narrower centre spindle, so it looks like a 120 spindle to me. So that's interesting. I don't know whether the bellows are leaking. We can... Not a very scientific way of doing it. I'll get a torch later and put that in there. Reasonably light tight to me, but you want to say I'll check it later with a torch. Yeah, it's in lovely condition. I can't remember how much I paid for it, it wasn't a lot, it was about £20-25, I think, something like that. So yeah, very pleased with that. Take fresh film in that side, winds across to there. Frame counter is through the back window. It'll just continuously wind. We have to line up the numbers. Which if you're a regular to the channel or you've used these sort of cameras before, you're quite well aware of that. It's got a cable release socket there for the standard screw-in cable release. And the focusing is on the front. It's a zone focusing system, so no depth of field scale, so that's a little bit interesting. F32, I think everything would be in the focus. 5 feet. So yeah, we'll put a roll of film through that at some point. Providing the bellows are light tight, I think we should have a quite useful camera. I do like 6x9 negatives, they're just so big. They even make the 6x7s look quite small. And then to fold it up again, and we just push down on these locking tabs and then it'll all fold away. If you're going hiking or walking up mountains or what have you, that's the way to go. Huge negative, really light. And now I do have a 6x9 enlarger, so I've been playing around with some 6x9 negatives and they're just incredible quality. I don't know the age of this. It's got to be fairly old, but it's a Zeiss camera, so it doesn't get a lot better than that. There you go, folks. Short video today, under 10 minutes. That's unusual for me. But yeah, just to let you know, more coming this week. I'm back from my little mini break last week. And what else have I got coming up this week? Oh yeah, Canon EOS 1N. review coming up that was requested by a viewer, and possibly some canonet repair stuff, because I seem to be getting a lot of questions about canonet repairs at the moment. But thank you very much for watching, hope you've enjoyed. If you got this far in the video and you want to see more or send me questions or whatever, please subscribe, like the video. Comments, questions, queries, whatever, about any kind of thing to do with photography, just drop it down in the comments section below. I do read and answer during up all comments now that I'm back on this full time really now, messing about with cameras, and I look forward to seeing the next one. Take care, bye.